While working on a project, we will need to navigate through it several times to modify the objects that are placed in it. To navigate through the drawing, we use certain navigation tools, and by certain navigation tools, I am referring to zoom, pan, and orbit. In this lesson, we will analyze how these tools work. As you can see in this example, a 3D building has been created. Let's start with the pan tool, which enables me to move the camera horizontally or vertically, or simply put, it enables me to move the view planar to the screen. The pan command is in the left toolbar and is depicted by a hand icon. By clicking on this icon, you will notice that the cursor takes the form of a hand, and by clicking somewhere in the drawing area, I can move the scene. I should mention here that I am not moving the object but rather the perspective to get a better view of the object. To deactivate the pan command, I will press escape. Another way to use the pan tool is to hold down shift and press the mouse wheel simultaneously while I move the cursor around. Note that the hand appears again, and I can move the view planar to the screen. Since you will use the pan command frequently, it's more convenient that you use the shortcut instead of the icon. The next navigation tool is orbit, which rotates the camera around a model. You can activate the orbit tool from the left toolbar, like the pan tool. I will click on the orbit icon, and I will click and drag inside the scene. Notice that the camera indeed rotates. I will press escape to deactivate the tool and show you the shortcut for orbit, which is what you will most likely use. I hold down both the control key and the mouse wheel simultaneously, and I will move the cursor around. Again, the camera rotates. Now I will show you how to zoom in and out in order to inspect certain parts of your model. The easiest way to zoom in or out is to hover the cursor where you want to zoom and move the scroll wheel forward. Similarly, by moving the scroll wheel backward, we can easily zoom out. Now let's see some other zoom options that can be found in the toolbar on the left. By choosing the zoom tool, I can hold down the mouse click and zoom in or out of the scene by moving the cursor around. By selecting the zoom window tool, I can create a window that encloses the objects I want to focus on. For example, I will create a zoom window to zoom in on one of the building's windows. Notice that the view has been enlarged, and now we can see the house's window clearly. The next option is zoom extends, and when I click on it, the drawing is aligned in the center of the screen and becomes as large as possible to be fully visible. Finally, the previous option takes you to the previous zoom state. At the bottom of the toolbar, there are three more navigation options. With the position camera, you click on a point in the design area, and the look around option is automatically activated, allowing you to inspect the scene as if you were actually in the scene. Simply hold down the click button and look around. The next option is walk, which simulates your movement as if you were walking inside the scene. Simply hold down the click button and set the direction. The further away you move the cursor, the faster the walking becomes. Before we finish the lesson, I will show you how to change the view of your object. For example, you can change the view to right, top, front, etc. From the Views toolbar, I will select the first icon. This tool changes the view to perspective. By clicking on the second top icon, the view changes to top view. By clicking the front icon, the view changes to front view, and so on.